Hello, good girls. Who wants a walkie? Who wants a walkie?
Well, we're off. We're off to the woods. I've got my lovely assistant, Mandy, my wife, helping me. She's holding the camera at the moment. I've got the two dogs in the back. I know many of you often ask about my two dogs. So, chance you to see them and see how they're doing. I don't bring them out with me much because, to be honest with you, they're a bit of a handful. Especially Carmen, and especially when I want to take any photographs, which I want to on this occasion. I've brought my camera equipment, so obviously when I'm taking photographs and dogs running around, it's not conducive to allow me to concentrate and get the pictures I want. So anyway, hopefully with Mandy's help and support, I'll be able to get some nice images and some nice video of the woods. Got my drone. Yeah, so it should be good. I'm not able to work in my workshop at the moment because I've had the surgery on my eye and I've got stitches in my eyelid. And I've got to keep out of a dusty environment. And in the workshop where I work as a knife maker, there's lots of abrasive dust and it's just not conducive to the healing process. So I've got more time to make videos. I've got a few videos coming up over the next few days. I'm going to be out quite a bit, possibly fitting in a wild and wet and windy woodland camp. That could be next. And then later on this week I'm off on the Royal Enfield Himalayan with my friend Dickie, and we're off over to Wales, and that'll be a motorcycle tent camping adventure as well. So all being well, it should be a productive week or two on the Wiltshire Man channel, so I hope you stay tuned. Anyway, now we're going to Savernake Forest, so I'll bring you back when we're there. Well, here's the two dogs. This one's Zeta. She's a completely nutcase crazy dog. We can't let her off the lead because she wants to go running away and hunting. So I got on an extending lead. She's about 2.5. She's constantly, as you can see, constantly on the go. Constantly. Carmen on the other hand, there's Carmen, totally trustworthy, never strays far away, always close. Carmen, good girl, very responsive, chalk and cheese, but they get on well together, which is the main thing. Well, there we are. There's the glamorous assistant there, Mandy.
Glamorous on life.
Yeah, she's going to try and help me, but it's so difficult when you've got a crazy dog tied to your waist. Well, I've got my stills camera, my Nikon, which is a D7500 with me, and I'm going to try. I've got my eyes peeled for a nice. I got my eyes peeled for a nice picture, but I haven't seen what I'm after just yet. So when I do, I'll get the other camera out and take a photo. But this little dog, she is a real handful. Constantly on the go. There's something quite appealing about this this look in the forest here. I don't know if there's a picture there or not. Might be worth getting the other camera out. I like how the forest sort of runs into the mistiness in the back in the distance there, giving the impression of that the forest goes on for a long way, which indeed it does. I think in that direction, I think it goes on for another 2 or 3 miles. Well, as you can see from the name, this is the White Road Oak, one of the many huge and ancient oak trees in Savernake Forest. There you go, look. No idea how old it is, 800 years perhaps, maybe a bit more, but it's quite a large tree. As you can see. For those of you that are interested, for those of you that are of a, what should we say, squeamish nature, that's right, and perhaps you all will see this little bit of the video, but for those of you that are interested and follow me on my knife making channel, etc., you know that I've been in for surgery on my eyelid. In a nutshell, I had a gold weight installed because my face became paralysed after a surgery I had many years ago. But anyway, there was a reaction and an allergic reaction, and my eyelid was swelling up and getting bigger and bigger, and it was closing my eye down. So in the end, it was decided to remove the gold weight. So I've been in hospital last week. I had the surgery to remove that, and there's still like a bump there. That's caused by scar tissue, I believe. And I got stitches. I don't know if you can see the stitches in there across the top. I got to have this special cream, antibiotic cream, that's applied to the eyelid every 3 or 4 hours. And I got to keep it clean and dust free, hence I'm not working for a little while. But hopefully the swelling will go down. I have got some facial movement back, so I can actually blink my eye. Not as effectively as a normal person. I'm a bit of an abnormal person, I'm afraid, with regarding that natural reflex, but I can actually sort of force it to blink. My dog's just getting herself wrapped around the tripod. She's hard work. Anyway,
We lever all the same. Right, onwards. Let's have a look down here. So I spotted these roots. It rather an inspiring, well, I don't know. No, they look nice. Is there a photograph there though? That's the thing. Is there a photograph there? Let's give it a try. If anyone's interested, that's the camera I'm using. I'm using the 18 to 140mm lens, so it's a lens I've not used much, so all the photographs in this video have been shot with that lens. Well, I'm heading back home now. Make sure that's focusing. Heading back home now, because the dogs are getting tired. Mandy's getting tired, she can't walk too far because she's got a bit of a health condition. Just spotted this lovely oak tree. I've just got to take this one last shot. Now I know none of these pictures really are anything more than happy snaps really, but all nice pleasant pictures to look at, but compositionally wise I know they're not up to much. It's just a bit of an adventure really to come out into the woods with the dogs. This little horrifidal here, come here, she's hard work, pulling all the time, always very alert all the time. Looking for squirrels, looking for foxes, anything.
And deer.
And deer. Anyway, this is the tree, I'll pan you round. Now Carmen's coming for a fuss. You're a good girl, you are. Not like horrified all.
Hello.
Yeah, she cut her ear yesterday when I was walking and it bled profusely. And that's what you can see there, but she's quite alright though. She did cut her ear. Anyway, let's show you this pit, this tree I'm going to take a photograph of. There you go, girl.
Hello.
So that's it. A lovely old oak. Hundreds of years old. I wonder what stories it could tell. Anyway, let's take a picture. It'll be the last one. Then we're heading back. If only Carmen would stay there. What do you reckon on that last picture? That
tree is nice. It's nice, yeah.
You think it's a nice picture?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, she does, yeah. We've got to stop, get this one last photograph before we go home. And there it is, look. That tree there, I think we can do something with that. Maybe. Fingers crossed. Well, there it is. There's the framing. But I will do it as a square crop, I think. I think it'll look nice as a square crop. Let's take the picture. Yeah, we're living in difficult, uncertain times at the moment, so I hope this video has brought a little bit of natural hope. I don't know what is it I can say? A bit of joy and peace and normality back to those that have watched it. So with that, I'll see you in the next video.
Bye for now.
Bye for now.
Come.